After that, when he has put, when he shall have,
they go for elections.
Yeah, he should step down and let there be a free fight. And you see, then my children, who were there are about three of them in the state, when I started talking about Southern Cameroon's system and the rest, those children, their mother is part Mfuni, part Bisomagam.
Mm-hmm.
Part
where?
Part Mfuni and Bisomagam.
Mfuni and Bisomagam.
Is man Manu.
Okay. Manfede, after Nchang. So they asked, Papa, you are talking this Southern Cameroon's thing. Where do people like us fall? Where do we fall? Because our cousins are all over there. I told them one thing. I said, look, you people have nothing to fear. Your grandfather, your grandmothers were Southern Cameroonians. By the same token, your father is a Southern Cameroonian. Good. And statehood, the sovereignty of a people, has nothing to do with blood relation, with genealogy, with genetics, and the rest. I say, you people are lucky today. When your grandfather was here, it took him 3 weeks from Bimbia to arrive the village. There were no telephones and nothing. But now, your father puts you in his 504. You leave here 4 o'clock in the morning. By 8, you are in Bafusa. There are telephones and the rest. The only thing will be that when Southern Cameroon comes, shall come, and you want to go see your brother, in your sister, in Wala, you shall be bearer of a Southern Cameroon's passport, and dependent on the arrangements which will be taken between two states, you will not be the only people divided. People must be divided because of state boundaries which have been there since 1932. You can go visit your people. Now it will take you less than 6 hours. You can go to Bafusa and come back the same day. So what is your problem? But my problem, our problem is that what we had got up to the Southern Cameroon's order in council of 1960, signed by the British government, that is the minimum. That is the minimum Southern Cameroon would have had in any arrangement, either with La République or with Nigeria. That is total self-government. But somebody up there is responsible for defense, is responsible for foreign affairs. That is what we have lost.
Are you talking of the federal system?
Yes, that is what...
Within the reunification?
Good, within that. At least, if that had not been denuded, tampered with, there would have been no problem. There would have been no...
No, but we have to come back. We have to even...
Good.
We have to come back to it.
We
have to restore it.
It's our duty. Road to Fumba and the road to that and the rest of it. And they have not said anything about the joint declaration made by Foncha and Endeli on the 26th of October 1961. God knows these people said that there should be no plebiscite in Southern Cameroon in 1961. They should keep it for 62. And Bile said they should put it off for 12 to 18 months. Then they ended up saying that they should continue, the two of them, they should continue with trusteeship. Britain would not mind. We should continue with trusteeship up to, with the separate, they should separate from Nigeria immediately. And by the 26th of October 1962, the trusteeship agreement should be ended in accordance with Article 76B of the Charter. I was shocked. The paper is there. So even those people have been condemning them, insulting them, and all that. The leaders, the people of Southern Cameroon, if the leader of the opposition, the government, come together to sign that type of declaration, was that not expressing the wishes of the people of Southern Cameroon? So for me, Anfoncha's argument at that time, why he did not subscribe to immediate negotiations with French Cameroons when they become independent. He said, it will be unthinkable for Southern Cameroons to hold talks, to negotiate with the French Cameroons government when Southern Cameroon is not free, is not independent. I have the paper.
Foncha did not come across throughout his political life,
yes,
up to the time when he was premier to vice president, yes, to whatever, chancellor. Yes. He did not come across as somebody with such reflection.
No, I have the paper. There are two things. Reuters in 1961 talked about the disagreement of the Southern Cameroon's delegation. After they had agreed, they disagreed over the questions to be put. Endless formulation was the first question. There was not that they agreed, but what do we do with the second question? Foncha said, the second question does not arise because he cannot talk about negotiating with French Cameroons when Southern Cameroons is not independent. And so he talked about modified trusteeship for a short time until we can stand on our own. And stand on our own was the language of the League of Nations Covenant. The mandate system was for the people to be brought up until they can stand, they could stand on their own. Foncha used that.
But when he entered into negotiations with Ahidjo, he did not really.
He went as.
He was not representative of the Southern Cameroon.
He was leader of the KNDP. He made it clear that he was talking with Ahidjo as leader of a. Because if he had been talking as leader of a government, he would have been charged with high treason. He had no right.
Was Folon not KNDP?
Folon was KNDP, but. No, those are. I think that Foncha was very legalistic in his approach. And after that joint declaration with Mr. Mbile and all that, I think there was no argument about. There should have been no argument about plebiscite.
We'll continue from there.
I am not against anything with, because eventually the question will be asked, who is going to give you that federation? They should give us federation. We want federation. How will it come about? Because I have been thinking of, if I had my way, to give a lecture, practical lecture, on the various forms of federation which have existed in history and which are existing today. If we do not know the various forms of federation, we shall fall into the trap of decentralization.
Okay, let me put the point again.
Yes.
I am saying,
yes,
as a founding member of CAMP, yes, to which you also belong, Mr. Zumafor,
yes,
the headaches we had very much, if people are honest, and which I should say occasioned the smooth sailing of the French and the Francophone government,
yes,
into dismantling,
yes,
even the little bit of contract that we had between them in 1961,
verbal contract, yes,
is the division between the Northwest and the Southwest. What a division, people can look at it and interpret it in different ways. But when I look at that division, I look at not because that we don't interact with each other, we don't eat the same food and that on the natural integration part, is because of the lack of effective political collaboration between the two people,
yes,
right? I mentioned that Suella came about because they were not comfortable and they were not in acceptance with the direction of Cameroon and reform movement, because we were advocating for a return to the bicultural federation,
yes,
as it was in 1961. And they came and said they didn't want anything to do with the Northwest on that basis. And they were advocating for a 10th state federation. Now, today, at that time, we could have given anything,
yes,
to get Southwesterners, their elites, to come up and say they support this. We've waited a long time.
And that was a problem.
That elite group were very much emerged in the governmental setup and the mechanization and incipidium and all that kind of stuff for self-serving reasons.
Hungry.
And they could not even dare accept even that there is an Anglophone problem.
They didn't.
Today, we have a reversal of that. Even if it's not in the totality in which we want.
No, but
the Southwest chiefs have written a memorandum complaining about the treatment of Anglophones, whether it be only in the language form or whatever, but they have voiced publicly something about that. Suella has done the same thing. We have an occasion by what was happening with the common law through the lawyers of the government requiring that submission be made in French in Bamenda, in the courts in Bamenda and all the like, which is emboldening these people very much to penetrate and do anything what they want. Now, Mr. Zumafor and Mr. Tenkem, I'm asking you, you people are on the grounds, you are in the battlefield here. What do we make of that? Where is the way forward?
The way forward. Is to maybe give all of them, lend them a hand, make them understand that you are welcoming them.
Lend who we are.
All those people who are not talking the language that.
Okay.
So we are here. We are in this thing together. At the time we said this thing some 25 years or 30 ago, we were misunderstood, misconstrued, misinterpreted. But life itself has taught us that where we are going is the road to extinction and destruction. So let us pull ourselves together and give them more cogent reasons for fighting, because even the lawyers are not quite clear in their heads about what they want. We had somebody here called Sopkan. I think you had just left. In 1996, Sopkan and I think we were 12 or 16 of us filed an originating summons in the Boya High Court asking La République, the president, to declare that Cameroon was a bilateral company. Our advocate, our solicitor was Charles Charles Takum.
Mm-hmm.
Tunde was part of the team. They sent one of those to give the lawyers a boost. Because the lawyers, they are lawyers, but they lack political education. They don't have any political education.
Okay.
That is the problem.
That there's something that you can do to boost the lawyers, whatever vision they had or did not have.
Yes.
They went to Bermuda and did their thing.
Yes.
What we need to do is to shake up behind it.
Correct.
Whatever we do, we shake up behind it and throw it. One of their leaders came here. We had when we were meeting together, the leaders were about 100 years ago here in this same spot. One of their leaders was coming here. So we're talking. So I have maintained, we have been in touch since then. So whatever we are doing in education, we are going together. Now, since after the work, I'm talking to someone, but I wrote to them again. I said, look, if the tournament are sitting another Francophone in his place, the first one will
not change.
So the man told me, yes. They are conscious of that and they are going to act. I said, fine. And I've been writing to all the sending messages to all these lawyers to go FACLA. FACLA lawyers. I said, no. We cannot see that. The temperature must be increased. We must continue to increase the temperature so that by the time those of us in the education sector we start coming in, when we start coming in, we know that at least there's quite a heat. And so that's actually we're talking about what kind of support they are going to have.
Yeah.
I think there is kind of support and there is potential to even more and better support.
Well, I do not think Swella or the Northwest and the Southwest chiefs or the lawyers need support. I will not expect a person like Fonu better to reflect and to speak the language of SCNC camp or anything. I think what we are doing is that
that we better now came out. So those things are happening, some of which we know, some of which we don't know.
Yes.
In actual fact, they had a meeting. The lawyers sent a delegation to meet the education people who are here.
Yes.
We had a meeting,
mm-hmm.
and we had to also do more contacts again to get people ready for further action.
Yes.
So I cannot tell you that the place is so quiet. But it's just that we want something that will hit the headlines and
something that is very disturbing, that is destructive too, is those where we don't listen, and when we don't listen, you don't follow the trend of things and you don't see opportunities. One disciple that might be difficult for you today might become the main disciple tomorrow that pushes you forward.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand? So we are very dismissive of people whom we think are not at the same level at the time in which we confront them. And we do ourselves in by doing that. And then again, not only that too, because we think that we have a just cause, we are also very painfully optimistic. You are optimistic, it's just like you must walk when you pray.
Yes.
You don't just say, I'm
God
praying to
get,
God and God is going to do everything
God get
because
pots.
I pray.
God know the cook.
Yes. So when I come and talk to people, they will say, oh, we're going to do this, we're going to... But you look behind.
He's doing
people will try to comfort themselves and say, oh, they are doing something in the background. Which is it that is in the background that nobody can see?
Nothing.
So I have been coming to this boya, like I told you. Mm-hmm. Even my friends with whom we were in jail here and all the like, I don't see anything in them.
Mm-hmm.
He's the one that I always see, I call and talk to. So what I would say is that let us not delude ourselves. And let us also not minimize or think that because events happen, we have beaten down the enemy. You see what I'm saying? Because we are dealing with people who have been very intelligent and they have played the game very well to our disadvantage. So those empty talks and things of make feel good and all the like that, okay, we are doing something when nothing is moving.
As I said, that law, for example, is seeming.
I agree with you entirely. In the action is very important in the liberation struggle. And I remember Asunwara in the 1992, 93, when he came to, when he was organizing TAC. I hope you follow.
Yeah.
The difference between the education sector and the legal and judiciary is that it is easier to mobilize teachers than it is to mobilize lawyers and judicial people. And Asunwara said one thing in 1993, 94, I think 95 or so. He said, we are liberating Southern Cameroons piecemeal by getting back the institutions of Southern Cameroons. At that time, how many institutions did we have? We just got the GCE board and the University of Yaoundé. And as what I said, if we could fight to get other institutions of the structure, that will play go a long way to liberating. Yes, to liberating. You have said we should not bother about what happened, you know, what held us back and the rest. But unfortunately, you of the Cameroon and Gofio movement, you naively, not knowingly, betrayed the trust which the people of Southern Cameroon had in us, gave us.
Mm-hmm.
That is, we were the leaders of the Southern Cameroon people. They did what we asked them to do. But we ourselves went to Bamenda in November 20th, 1995, and transferred our sovereignty to the SCNC. They were the sole.
That's 94.
No,
94.
After it was
AAC2, right?
No, after AAC2.
Oh, after AAC, okay.
I mean, come AGM of 1995, whatever. Yongbang was in Adelaide, somewhere there, attending the Commonwealth Conference. We held the general meeting where Mfomfor was chairing the meeting, and we surrendered ourselves, you know, bound ourselves, manacled, you know, chained and handed over to the SNC without bothering to know, to see whether those people were capable of carrying the Southern Cameroon people further. In less than 4 months, they abdicated. Less than 4 months. So we may be, this education sector, when we should revive TAC and mobilize the teachers. Now we have reason. The statistics you have just read here are provocative.
Revived. Yes, TAC is already revived.
Good.
It is happening.
So
TAC is already revived.
I am part of it because when after a camp meeting, we went Asunwara, Dio, and I, you know, I was chargé de mission from camp in all those things. We went and we planted the signboard of
the GC board.
You know, examinations board.
Yes.
Not GC, examinations board. We planted it. Yuan Emsek Atem, the policeman, we had hardly turned our faces when he removed it and threw. And I said, you had hung yourself. We came back. And it looks like Camp 2 also took long sabbatical leave. I would like to know that it is now revived because I am part of it.
Where's your man?
Yongbang is sick, eh?
See, let us look at it this way.
Yes.
Whether it is camp or SNC or whatever, that name does not matter.
Correct.
It is the individuals. You see what is wrong. Yeah. You don't need to, I don't need to call myself SNC.
No.
I have some colleagues in the office. You want to say to them, no, I'm neither CPDM nor SDM nor SNC. I said, no, are you born, are your parents, are you born of Southern Cameroon? Are you
what is called Anglophone, are you a citizen of Southern Cameroon? He said, "I say whether you like it or
you
not,
you cannot be neutral.
You are STL, you are SCNC.
You see,
you are SCNC. Don't pretend.
Ebini.
In those days when people used to sit on the fence, it does not work anymore.
I don't know. You are not a Catholic. Mother Teresa, a saint now, said of all the crimes, of all the sins that can be committed, the greatest sin is indifference. When weak contends with strong, where evil contends with what is true, with might contends with meek,
you cannot be indifferent.
You cannot be neutral. Because when you say you are neutral, you are backing the wrong,
yes.
You are backing the oppressor.
Yes.
Either you are eating from the oppressor, or you want to be seen and be given.
I cannot say that I'm neither.
No, don't say that.
It's
so, in summary, then,
yes.
What are you guys suggesting?
To intensify.
I mean, I want you to,
what
to say something that energizes both the people on the home front and the diaspora.
Yes. No,
my suggestion is this. The lawyers are already.
If you have any strategies that you can suggest to them, give it to them. For example, there was one point where after the.
Working in those places, if our TAC is revived.
It is revived.
Now, we should hold first, maybe either for co-executive or some type of executive, analyze the present situation of education.
It's been done.
And then at a meeting, whilst you are taking resolutions on those things, you take resolution supporting the lawyers in their just demands.
It's been done.
Please, when next you are meeting, when next you are meeting, you know, let me know. Let me come and share with you. Because the lawyers need to know that the common law system suffered a very, very fatal blow when they dissolved the West Cameroon Bar Association to form that national thing. They should never have allowed the West Cameroon Bar Association.
It can be revived now. In actual fact, for me,
yes.
when they were telling me that, they said, no, that's good. In fact, we shall all do the
be
advocacy
together.
So that's why they said at the beginning, they came here, we had a meeting with the education sector, a small meeting, but what the ideas that came there, we're using it to expand.
Yes.
Okay, well, you say your meeting is on Saturday, right?
Yes.
Okay, so unfortunately I won't be here, but I'll get Mr. Zumafor as an old camper. I'll be meeting with Bisha and Dwala.
Yes, but I will be, you know, for TAC and education sector.
Yes.
You know, I retired from the education, from the delegation of education.
Yes.
Do you know that?
Okay.
I was there for.
I didn't know.
No, I retired from education.
Okay.
I was there up to 1992, in charge of examinations and all that type of thing, while doing my own thing. I was the last professor agrégé to be appointed by Mr. Ahijo, the last professor agrégé appointed in 1977, before the change.
Let's meet tomorrow.